The following module talks about the different concepts and definitions of morbidity, the sources of morbidity statistics, measures of morbidity, and examples. The study of morbidity is often said to deal with the investigation of illness, sickness, or disease in any particular population, and a morbidity condition appears or comes into being due to one or more diseases or through injury. There are other important terms such as impairment, disability, and handicap, which is also used to describe morbidity conditions, which are described in the following module. Morbidity statistics are available from many different sources, including, for example, cases that arise from the staff of primary health care centers, clinics, etc., and also the hospital records of inpatients, outpatients, and special sickness surveys. Important measures of morbidity include the incident rate, the prevalence rate, the duration of illness, relative risk, disability rates, and important terms which are commonly used as DALE, that is Disability Adjusted Life Expectancy, change to HALE, Healthy Life Expectancy, Quality Adjusted Life Years, QALY, and Disability Free Life Expectancy, DFLE, all of which you will come across in this module.
I am Dr. C.P. Prakasham, retired professor from International Institute for Population Sciences, Mumbai. Module 4, Concept and Definitions of Morbidity. Learning Objectives. In this module, we will learn about concepts and definitions of morbidity, definition of morbidity, sources of morbidity statistics, measures of morbidity, examples. Definition of morbidity. According to the Multilingual Demographic Dictionary, the study of morbidity deals with the investigations of illness, sickness, ill health, or disease in a population. According to J.B. Stallman, 1988, morbidity is the extent of illness, disease, injury, or disability in a defined population. In the recent period, life expectancy has been extended to include morbidity and disability. Morbidity or sickness, also understood as the means of departure from being healthy condition. Though death is well defined, morbidity or sickness is the state between perfect health and death, whose identification depends upon both the criteria used and the type of observations applied to them. Morbid condition appears due to one or more disease or injury. The term disease denotes a disturbance in the normal physical and or mental health. This disturbance may not be apparent but discovered only after special investigations, namely serology, radiology, histology, etc. The term injury is a condition produced by an external cause such as violence, accident, poisoning. Another three terms, namely impairment, disability, and handicap, also described morbidity condition. The sequence of events leading to disability is as follows. Disease leads to impairment, leads to disability, leads to handicap. Impairment is defined as any loss or abnormalities of physiological, psychological, or autonomical structure or function. Disability is defined as any restriction or lack of resulting from impairment of ability to perform an activity in the manner or within the range considered normal for a human being. Handicap is defined as a advantage for a given individual resulting from an impairment or a disability that limits or prevents the fulfillment of a role that is normal, depending upon age, sex, and social and cultural factors for that individual. Example, accident, disease or disorder, loss of foot, impairment, eccentric or intrinsic, cannot walk, disability, objectified, unemployed, handicap, socialized. Sources of morbidity statistics. Availability of morbidity statistics from the following sources. Number one, hospital records of inpatients together with records of attendance of outpatients in hospitals, clinic and dispensaries. Number two, cases examined by the staff of primary health care centers, clinics, school medical services, medical service by factory medical staff and other medical staff responsible for special group of population. Number three, special sickness surveys covering the whole and sample population. Number four, statistics on illness collected in connection with the life or sickness insurance. Five, statistics collected under community medical care programs. Six, national or local registers on cancer tuberculosis. Number seven, statistics of cause of death in relation to knowledge of duration of illness if recorded. And many more health and survey reports. Measures of morbidity. The WHO Experts Committee on Health Statistics noted in its sixth report that morbidity could be measured in terms of three units: A, persons who were ill; B, the illness period or spell or illness that these persons experienced; and C, the duration, days, weeks, etc. of these illnesses. Illness exists in a given time period as follows: illness beginning during the period and ending during the period; illness beginning during the period and still existing at the end of the period; illness existing before the beginning of the period and ending during the period; illness existing before the beginning of the period and existing at the end of the period. Measures: disease, illness or sickness measured by calculating, number one, incident rate; number two, prevalence rate; period prevalence rate, point prevalence rate; number three, attack rate, secondary attack rate; number four, case fatality rate; number five, duration of illness or sickness; number six, relative risk, attributable risk and odds ratio; number seven, other measures, disability rate, HALE, QALY, DFLE and DALY. In this module, above measures will be discussed with examples. Incident rate. Incident rate IR equals to number of new cases of specific disease during a given time period whole divided by population at risk during that period multiplied by 1000. Example, the mid-year population of Greater Bombay in 2003 was 11,506,042 and total number of new cases of malaria detected by different hospitals in Greater Bombay was 66,402. What was the IR? As per the above formula, incident rate of malaria in Greater Mumbai equals to 66,402 divided by 11,506,042 multiplied by 1000 equals to 5.77. Incident rate of malaria in Greater Mumbai in 2003 year was 5.77 per 1000 population. Usually, the period of study is chosen to be 1 year, in which case it would be called as the annual incidence. Prevalence rate, point prevalence, period prevalence. Point prevalence refers to the proportion of the population that is diseased to a single point in time. The point can be either a particular calendar date. Period prevalence refers to the proportion of the population that is diseased during specified duration of time, a particular year. The period prevalence include the number of cases that were present at the start of the period as well as the number that developed during the period. Point prevalence equals to number of existing cases of disease at a point of time divided by number of total population at the same point of time. Period prevalence, number of existing cases of diseases during a period of time divided by number of total population. In the two measures, the numerator, existing cases, is a subject of the denominator, total population. The numerator includes all currently living cases regardless of when they first developed. The denominator includes everyone in the population, either sick, healthy, at risk, and not at risk, because prevalence is a proportion, it is dimensionless, and it is possible value range from 0 to 1 or 0 to 100%. Example, point prevalence. On 26th December 1996, 1000 have hypertension among 10,000 families residing in town A. The prevalence of hypertension among women in town A on this date is calculated as 1000 divided by 10,000 equals to 0.1 or 10%. Relationship between prevalence and incidence. Prevalence depends upon the rate at which new cases of disease developed, that is incident rate, as well as the duration or length of time that individuals have the disease. The relationship between prevalence and incident rate is as follows. P by 1 minus P equals to I into D, where P is the proportion of the total population with the disease and I is the incident rate, and 1 minus P is the proportion of the total population without the disease. A population in which the number of people with and without the disease remains stable is known as a steady state population. In such theoretical circumstances, the point prevalence of disease is approximately equal to the product of the incident rate and the mean duration of the disease, that is P equals to I into D. Attack rate. Attack rate equals to number of new cases of specified disease during its specified time interval whole divided by total population at risk during the same interval multiplied by 100. Secondary attack rate. Secondary attack equals to number of exposed person developing the disease within the range of the incubation period whole divided by total number of exposed susceptible contact multiplied by 100. Duration of illness. A. Average duration of illness per person equals to total days of illness of all sick person whole divided by total population exposed. B. Average duration of illness per person sick, total days of illness of all sick persons divided by total number of persons fell ill. C. Average duration of illness per spell, total days of illness of all sick persons divided by number of spell of illness. Relative risk, RR, incidence of disease or death among exposed whole divided by incidence of disease or death among non-exposed. Example, it is intended to measure association between cancer and smoking. Cigarette smoking, yes, no. developed cancer, not developed cancer, total. 80, that is A, not developed cancer, 3200 B, total 4000 A plus B. Developed cancer, no, 6, that is C, not developed cancer, 4994, that is D, 5000 is a total C plus D. Relative risk equals to A by A plus B equals to 80 divided by 4000 multiplied by 1000 equals to 2.0. Relative risk equals to C divided by C plus D equals to 6 by 5000 multiplied by 1000 equals to 1.2. Relative risk equals to A by A plus B whole divided by C plus C by C plus D equals to 2.0 divided by 1.2 equals to 1.67. Relative risk is a ratio and a direct measure of the strength of the association between suspected cause, cigarette smoking in the above example, and effect, developed cancer. Relative risk greater than 1 suggests positive association. In the above example, relative risk is 1.67, means that cigarette smoking causes cancer 1.67 times more among smokers than non-smokers. A relative risk less than 1 indicates a reduction in the incident rate in exposed individuals as compared with unexposed. Disability rates. In the recent period, death rates have not changed markedly, and hence disability rate related to illness and injury have come into use to supplement mortality and morbidity indicators. The commonly used disability rate fall into two categories: A, event type indicators, and B, person type indicators. A, event type indicators. Number 1, number of days of restricted activities. Number 2, bed disability days. Number 3, work loss days for school loss days within a specified period. B, person type indicators. Number 1, limitation of mobility, confined to bed, confined to house. Number 2, limitation of activity, limitation of performing the basic activities of daily living, ADL, namely eating, washing, dressing, going to toilet, moving around, limitation of doing specific job. Health adjusted life expectancy, HALE. The disability adjusted life expectancy, DALE, has been changed to healthy life expectancy, HALE. HALE is based on life expectancy at birth, but includes an adjustment for the time spent in poor health. HALE defined as the number of years in full health that a newborn can expect it to live based on current rate of ill health and mortality. Quality adjusted life years, QALY, QALY is a measure of disease burden, including both the quality and quantity of life lived. It is burden in assessing the value of money of a medical intervention. The QALY is based on number of years of life that would have lived with perfect life with the medical intervention. DALY, DALY, basic facts. DALY were first reported in World Development Report 1993. Number 2, DALY is a new composition indicator of population health status and express the burden of morbidity and mortality. 3, DALY were designed with cost effectiveness analysis in mind. Disability free life expectancy, DFLE. DFLE is the average number of years an individual is expected to live free of disability if current pattern of mortality and disability continues to apply. DALY is a measure of overall disease burden expressed as a number of years lost due to ill health, disability or early death, it captures the population impact of important fatal and non-fatal disabling conditions through a single measure. The major measure used is Disability Adjusted Life Year, DALY, which is combined YLL and YLD as years of lost life, YLL, calculated from the number of deaths at each age multiplied by the expected remaining years of life according to a global standard life expectancy. Years lost to disability, YLD, calculated by multiplying number of incident cases due to injury and illness by the average duration of the disease and a weighting factor reflecting the severity of the disease on scale from 0, perfect health, to 1, dead. Reference. These are the important reference where you can see about this module. Questions. Number 1. Define the term morbidity. 2. What are the sources of morbidity statistics? 3. Define and discuss the term 1. Disease. 2. Impairment. 3. Disability. 4. Handicap. 4. Discuss any two measures of morbidity. 5. Write note on HALE DALY. Fill in the blanks.